Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, and today I'm here for an album review, and the album I'm reviewing is going to be Day of the Dead by Hollywood Undead. Been wanting to review it since I had it on CD, and this is a pretty good album from these guys, so let's go and get started with this review. Alright, so as you guys already know, I won't be talking about all of the songs on the album, just some, or about four or five, but we'll decide on that as we go. But yeah, other than that though, let's go and get started with this album review. Alright, so the first song on the album I want to talk about is the opening track, Usual Suspects. This one has its mixture of the rap rock style mixed in with some dubstep, and I know some people who are fans of the band complain about that, but they've done a lot worse with their discography. So yeah, this isn't like the worst thing they ever did, like some people would make it out to be, you know, but that's just my opinion. I really like this song. Sure, it's not their best song ever, but it's still a good song though, and I really like it. So it's one of my favorites on the album, and I think it's a great album opener. Great choice to begin an album. Alright, also want to mention the song How We Roll, of course, because this is a all-time favorite song for me when it comes to Hollywood Undead, not just from this album, but the band in general. Definitely a great song. I really enjoy the chorus on this one. Always want to singing along. Always catch myself singing along and wanting to have fun every time that chorus kicks in. It's just so catchy and just a fantastic chorus. Danny's voice when he sings on this, it's just amazing, man. Definitely one of his best choruses that he ever did since he's been in this band. But that's just me though. Definitely a great song though. One of my favorites on the album. So War Child is another song I want to bring up. I won't have much to say about it because it is one of my least favorites on the album, but I'll talk about it anyway. So yeah, War Child is one of my least favorites on the album. I don't really care for the song as much as some of the other songs. I think this one was a single, I don't remember, but if it was, then it's definitely my least favorite out of the singles. So yeah, it's not necessarily a bad song. I just find it kind of cringe-worthy, and I don't really like Danny's vocals on this track. It's just not all that good. So yeah, this song is worth skipping if you ask me. Not a terrible song or anything. There's worse in the world, of course, but just not one of the better songs on the album. So yeah, it has been a least favorite for me. I also liked the song Dark Places. This song is pretty underrated if you ask me. Definitely a great song though. I really like that one. It's got a really good chorus again. So yeah, Dark Places is worth checking out. Definitely a great song. Gravity is another song on this album that I really like. I mean, I do think it's one of the weaker songs on the album, especially with the chorus from Danny. I think he could have done better, but I still think it's a good song overall, despite the weakness that it has within the song itself. But it is still a damn great song though. Despite it being one of the weaker songs on the album, I still do tend to enjoy this song though. So Gravity, just because it's a weaker song doesn't mean it's a least favorite for me, because it's not a least favorite, because it is a good song and I still do enjoy it. Another song on this album that I find cringe and as least favorite would be the song Does Everybody in the World Have to Die. Just find the song, once again, cringe-worthy, even more cringe than War Child. Even though when I do still think War Child is cringe, I think Does Everybody in the World Have to Die is even more cringe. I just don't like how Johnny Three Tears presents himself within the chorus of the song, or whatever part it is in the song. I just don't like that about the song. So yeah, it's definitely a cringe song. I don't like it. Terrible. Well, I wouldn't say terrible, but cringe at best. Not a good song. Don't care for it. Party By Myself was a good song. I enjoyed it. So yeah, Party By Myself, you also have a catchy chorus with this one, but this one is a really good song. I really enjoy Party By Myself. Definitely one of my favorites on the album outside of the singles. So yeah, Party By Myself, definitely a great track. I really enjoy this one every time I listen to the album. Alright, so we'll close off with talking about the closing track, Save Me. And yeah, Save Me is a great song. I think it was a really great choice to end off this album because they done it the right way. So yeah, definitely a great album closer. I'm glad they didn't pick a cringe song to end off the album. So that's awesome, of course. But yep, Save Me, definitely a great song, pretty underrated in their discography. So yeah, with that being said, that's gonna wrap it up for me talking about the songs. I know I didn't want to mention a lot of the songs, but this album has a lot of great songs on it, so I had to mention more than just 3 or 4 songs like I normally would in any other album review. So yeah, this is not one of their best albums, but it still is a good album for what it is. It's not one of my least favorites from the band, but it's not their best by any means. But it still is a good album overall, at least in my opinion. I really like the sound they've done with this album and took dubstep with the opening track, Usual Suspects. That was awesome. They tried to make a couple songs work, but they failed on that because those two songs are cringe, those being War Child and Does Everybody in the World Have to Die, whatever that damn song's called. I don't even give a fuck at this point because I do not like that song. It's one of the worst songs Hollywood Undead has ever did. So yeah, this album though, regardless, is a good album, just not one of their best. I still do like it though. So with that being said, it's time to rate Day of the Dead by Hollywood Undead. So the album itself is good, just don't care for a couple tracks. But yeah, with that being said, I still think it's a good album. So this album gets a 8 out of a 10 rating. But yeah guys, let me know what y'all think of Day of the Dead by Hollywood Undead. And let me know some of your favorite songs on the album and all that good stuff. So yeah, this album receives an 8 out of 10 rating for me. But yeah, with that being said, thank you all for watching. I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace.